In this episode of Minute GarageBand, we're going to show you why controls may appear to be missing in GarageBand version 10. GarageBand version 10 has a minimum window width of about 1340 pixels. Once you go below that, certain controls are hidden. If you've watched any of our previous GarageBand version 10 videos, you may have noticed, for instance, that the master volume fader is missing. That's because these videos are done in 720p, which has a width of 1280, below the 1340 threshold. In this one, we've allowed the right edge of the window to go out of capture range to show the fader. But as we reduce the width to bring the entire window into view, you can watch it vanish. As we continue to shrink the width, more controls vanish. First, the notepad, loop, and media buttons, followed by the forward and metronome buttons, continuing until the library, quick help, smart controls, and editor buttons vanish, at which point some of the other controls return. So what do you do if you need these buttons? The obvious answer is to set your monitor to a higher resolution so that you can expand the window's width. But if that's not an option, you can still toggle these controls via the more arrows. However, that still leaves the master volume fader. To access this control, simply show the master track and use the fader located in the track header. Note that as of version 10.0.0, the thumbs of these controls are not synced. Sliding one does not change the position of the other. This means that even though one master fader is showing the project at full volume, if the other is at zero, you won't hear anything. So in general, it's best to use one or the other, but not both at the same time. That's all we have for this episode. We hope you found it useful. And for more, subscribe to our YouTube channel. So long. Well, some said they weren't, Chief, but you know how politicians lie.